Now, I would like to give my project a title theme, and there are various options to help us do this. I'll use the title track, which is available for us here, labelled 1T, T for title. And here, I can create a new title by right-mouse-clicking within the track at an empty position, and from the context menu, New Clip, I can call the Quick Titler. The Quick Titler opens, and I will move it off screen for a second, as I can see that when inserting the title, a large gap has appeared. From the basics that we learnt earlier, we can certainly see why. The insert mode was active, and therefore all the clips following the title that we created have been shifted to the right, and this is clearly wrong. So I close Titler, and the procedure is undone, as we hadn't confirmed it yet. I'll now change to overwrite mode and go to the title track, right mouse button, New Clip, Quick Titler. The Quick Titler has many functions, which we will go into in a more detailed tutorial, but again, in the scope of our beginner's tutorial, I will limit myself to showing the basics. I'll adjust the screen a little. We have a floating cursor here, which we know from word processors, and I can write a title directly, and I will call it At the Airport. And when we have activated the text, we can adjust the text properties here to the right. The most important for me now is the size. This can be adjusted from the drop-down field, up to a maximum of 72 only. But I can type another number directly into it, such as 120, or even 200. The design of the text isn't great in my opinion either, and so I can choose a new look directly from the design templates here. Double-click on the text, and then readjust the size. I could also choose a different font, but for a video title, Arial Black suits me fine. Now I would like to add additional words to the text, and so I click and add my text. We can see that the text is centered. If we wanted to change this, I could adjust it by going into the text properties here, left tab, center, right tab. I'll leave it in the center, and now I would like to have the entire text centered on the screen. And to do this, I go to Layout, Center in Screen, and first Horizontal, and then Vertical. With this, the text is finished as far as I am concerned, and I can click on Preview to see it in full quality. I get the impression that it is not well differentiated from the background, and so I would like to add a shadow, and the shadow options can be found in the text properties. I'll go to the soft width parameter, and by clicking here, and with the mouse button held, I can adjust the values. And here, I can adjust the angle, and the distance. I'll once again have a look in preview mode, and when I am happy, I can click on the diskette icon to save and exit back into my project. We can see that the text has been inserted correctly, and EDIUS automatically creates a fade in and a fade out. If the position of the title doesn't suit me, then I can adjust it easily to avoid the title and crossfades interfering with each other, as we have seen before when moving other clips. And I can also adjust the length, as we have seen previously too. After the title has been created, I can see a new clip in my folder, which we were in previously. And that is nothing other than my newly created title clip. To keep some order in my folders, I will also create a new folder in my root folder for my titles, called Titles, by right mouse click, New Folder, Titles. and then I will move my clip into that folder.
At this point, I'd like to offer some extra information on the creation and use of video titles. You can place titles not only here in the title track, but also directly into a video track. The advantage of placing titles in the video track is that certain advanced effects and video options are only available to clips in a video track. These more advanced uses will be covered further in our more detailed tutorials. I would like to show in this small example one method with which we can place a title directly into a video track. Further methods will be shown in our more detailed tutorials. So here is our simple method. I'll drag this V into this area of my video track 2V. And now I call up the Create Title function and choose the Create Title in Video Track option. The video track I marked with my V will now be used. And now I can input my title's text. And then my title is placed in the video track 2V. Of course, you can move title clips to other tracks later as desired, simply by dragging and dropping. When doing this, you have to, however, make sure you are in the correct mode to ensure that you don't move clips by mistake. These topics will be discussed in more detail with all their available options in our more advanced tutorials. Click here for the next video. To subscribe to our YouTube channel, click here. You can find more tips and tricks in our EDIUS podcast. And this playlist contains the complete EDIUS tutorial.